reflector. So I am considering model problem for penetrable sphere. This attached rigid spherical reflector. Excited structure is excited by acoustic plane wave. Next one. The brief content of my presentation, introduction. As introduction, I will consider spatial distribution of acoustic pressure from a penetrable sphere without attached spherical shell excited by acoustic wave. And then in the presentation, I will consider same physical results for penetrable sphere, this attached hard, acoustically hard spherical shell. Theoretical background, mathematically rigorous solution obtained by using method of analytical regularization. Problem is formulated as dual series equations, these associated Legendre polynomials. Then we solve this system of equations by method of analytical regularization and came to solving well-conditioned infinite systems of linear algebraic equations. Then I will, which effectively solved by truncation method, very easy matrix filling, guaranteed convergence of truncated system, convergence of solution to truncated system to exact solution, which is for infinite system. And then for numerical results, I will analyze frequency dependence of sonar and total cross sections of sphere, this attached spherical cap. Here we see the problem structure. First, without attachment of spherical cap. So it's a sound penetrable sphere. This material parameter rho one and v one, where rho one is density of medium inside the sphere. V one is sound speed in this medium, and parameters P rho and V no V not are parameters of host acoustic medium outside of this sphere. This sphere excited by plane acoustic wave. In the solution, we also use parameter G, density contrast ratio of density of medium of the sphere and outside medium. And H is speed contrast or refraction index ratio of speed sound speed in the host medium to medium inside the sphere. As far as I understand, the first solution to this problem was arrived by Anderson in 1950 by use of Mi theory. In the following numerical results, I will use the following mediums. These rho and v material parameters presented in the paper by Lopez and Candelas in 2019. I will show results for pressure density spatial distribution for spheres, these hexane, ethanol and methyl iodide inserted in water. Host medium is water. Now we illustrate focusing effect of spherical acoustic lens by calculation of spatial distribution of acoustic pressure for three mediums. That's a sphere, this ethanol. You can see pressure distribution. No spherical cap here, just sphere alone, and pressure distribution along z-axis presented here. Then the next is a sphere filled this hexane frequency here. Radius of the sphere is 5 wavelengths, pressure distribution along z-axis. So we see focusing characteristics of this sphere. And sphere filled with methyl iodide. The results, these presented results, exactly coincide with those known in literature. Then let me say about scattering of obliquely incident plane wave by rigid spherical shell, the circular aperture, or essentially spherical cap, without attached sphere. This solution for spherical cap has a long history. This problem has a long history, and some of early publications are by Collins, Thomas, Miles, as early as 1962. All these solutions obtained solutions not always uniformly valid this respective aperture size. A more accurate solution was obtained in this publication, that's a book by Vinogradov, Smith, Vinogradova, published in 2002, where solution was obtained by using method of analytical regularization. Solution is uniformly valid, respectively size of all parameters, any size of spherical cap, which can be very small or very large, nearly closed sphere, obliquely incident waves, and solution is valid in scattering regions from relay scattering, then passing through resonance region and entering the high frequency region. And the accuracy of computations is controlled by the correct choice of truncation number, which is actually not should be so big. And examples of calculations of frequency dependence of normalized sonar cross sections are presented below. That's in logarithmic scale. And here you can see that size of the sphere frequency size is ranging from radius near close to zero on presented pictures until 50 wavelengths. For various sizes of spherical cap. That's just demonstration of capability of obtained solution. No limitations on parameters. Then, this accurate rigorous solution for scattering problem from rigid sphere, the circular aperture, so spherical shell. And along these properties of sound penetrable sphere leads to idea to simulate powerful acoustic reflector by attaching of spherical cap, rigid spherical cap, to the sound penetrable sphere. And consider it in the consider the focusing region of such structure. That should cause strong backscattering similar to that which exists in electromagnetic case. In the paper by Vinogradov in 2007, it was considered spherical dielectric lens reflector. And now we are considering acoustic problem. Such structure or comparable structure has been examined in the presentation, in some presentations and from a variety of papers. I present here the paper, which involves Janus sphere by Stuart Hawkins and Kofers, recently published in JASA. Now, let's consider the structure and theoretical background. So, we are looking on sound penetrable sphere, this attached hard spherical cap. Structure is excited by plain sound with acoustic wave. And as I already introduced, density contrast parameter G, speed contrast or reflection index H, then angular size, angular semi-width of the cap is here theta naught. That's latitude spherical coordinate theta. That's theta naught, size of cap, and incidence angle alpha, counted from positive z direction. Counted from positive z direction. Then we formulate the problem in terms of acoustic pressure, P naught, that's incident on sound penetrable sphere. That's representation by infinite series involving spherical Bessel functions and associated Legendre functions, normalized associated Legendre functions. Then the total field inside the sphere and outside the sphere, presented like that, by series, where Hankel and spherical Bessel functions known, associated Legendre functions known, and x naught and x1 are unknown coefficients, Fourier coefficients that should be found. Then mathematically rigorous formulation of the problem is the following, which result in a unique solution. That solution should satisfy Helmholtz equation. Then scattered field at infinity should behave as outgoing spherical wave. Then normal radial velocity should be continuous at the complete spherical interface.
That's 14 minutes, Elena. Sorry to interrupt.
Fine. So mathematically rigorous statement, then we solve by method of we obtain dual series equations after satisfying boundary conditions using technique of method. We introduce asymptotically small parameter and then following all steps, obtain the finite system of equations to solve, where right-hand side derived from known functions incident field, and here matrix elements, this one epsilon times q, are calculated using recurrence relations. So no integration, nothing. And system of second kind, this fast convergence is fast convergence. Then about calculations, here truncation error presented for the structure, for the sphere, this methyl iodide inside. And you see that solution to the system is fast convergent, this increasing truncation number. Then numerical results. Numerical results, we are considering penetrable sphere, this spherical cap attached. Attachment of spherical cap leads to essential growth of backscattering. Sonar cross-section, here sonar cross-section, logarithmic scale, and diameter of the sphere ranging from nearly zero wavelength, number of wavelengths, to 100 wavelengths. In red, no spherical cap, just sphere. And then here we see the spherical cap is increasing in size from 5 to 30 degrees, and the backscattering is increasing. For ethanol sphere here. And here is total cross section. Then on the next figure, we see that growth of backscattering is not so dramatic as before for ethanol sphere. Here, ethanol sphere. It's explained by higher density of explained by higher density of methyl iodide compared to ethanol. Ethanol on the previous slide, and here methyl iodide sphere. Then the next slide shows this the hemisphere reflector. So we have penetrable sphere and hemispherical rigid reflector. It can be seen from this plot, sonar cross-section for small caps, for small caps, red no cap, then size of cap increasing. Sorry, it's not cap, it's incident angle. Hemispherical rigid reflector and incident angle is changing from 0 degrees normal incidence to 45 degrees. And here it's continue to grow until near 90 degrees. It can be seen from this plot that under increase of incidence angle, effectiveness of the backscattering drops.
So yeah, here, I'm sorry to interrupt, Elena. I think we might need to move on in about a minute.
Yes, this effect is more pronounced for incidence angle approaching 90 degrees. Approaching 90 degrees, and here, the same results from methyl iodide field sphere. And frequency dependence of sonar cross-section, short comments, comparison of backscattering for just single sound, sound penetrable sphere, this different density contrast, pectane, just smaller, and here for methyl iodide larger, reveals incomparably higher reflectivity for sphere filled by medium, this higher densities. It's due to stronger reflections from interface separating two mediums, these pronounced contrasting densities. Then the second comment. For normal incidence, the growth of backscattering level for the same sphere, this attached rigid spherical cap, is readily explained as cap intercepts the focused acoustic radiation at antipodal point of sphere and reflects it back. Since the most intensity of acoustic field, this focal spot is
I'm really sorry to jump in, Elena. I think we might need a final comment and then stop and move on.
And final comment, when incident angle between normal and 90 degrees, it's rational to use attached hemisphere to provide the strong backscattering in extended diapason on an incidence angle. And actually that's it. And conclusions derived accurate solution to this model. And we can consider very large objects in frequency. So that's it. Let me finish.
Thank you. Thank you very much.